one's down?
God brought us to Nephi, truly. We both woke up one morning in a very comfortable circumstance. And it was a Sunday morning as well. What are you thinking, dear? You don't want to know. What are you thinking? You totally don't want to know. We were both thinking that we needed to move to Nephi. Yeah. So, literally, I believe in, you know, personal revelation and inspiration to give us guidance in our lives, and left a great job. But, you know, I'm not going to lie, there's sometimes we think, oh my heavens, how would life be if we would have stayed? Never know.
How's everybody doing? Thanks for coming out. Thank you. I love Nephi. Where's Andy at? Thanks for letting us use your yard. This is called Cody, and it's basically about I sort of combined a few friends' big brothers into this one bad dude, and that's what Cody is.
Says he didn't start the fire. His parents know he probably did. He's always playing with the light. He's just a different kind of kid. Cody says he didn't raise the dead. He says religion's just a trick. to keep hardworking folks in line. He says it makes his stomach sick. So who's gonna carry us away? Eagles with glory painted wings. We keep on waiting for the miracle to come. Pour down the mountain like a heaven-fed stream. Cody's always got one on the line. He likes to walk them by the wrist. He does his pulling with his eyes. He does his talking with his fist. Bottle rockets on an August night. Raid the coolers in the trucks. If we're lucky, we'll get loud and we'll drink whiskey from a plastic jug. So who's gonna carry us away? Eagles with glory painted wings. We keep on waiting for the miracle to come. Fall from the firmament and give us nice things. Round and round it goes. Where it stops, nobody knows. So who's gonna carry us away? Eagles with glory painted wings. We keep on waiting for the miracle to come. Roll down the mountain to the sound of sad strings. We keep on waiting for the miracle. For the miracle. We keep on waiting for the miracle. For the miracle.
She was dating a friend of mine, and I talked to him, and I seen her and thought that she was much too hot for him, so I knew she was working here, and I come here to get a cheeseburger and ended up with her.
I was waiting on his friend. You could see him through the window. Tall, dark, and handsome, and he had a big black cowboy hat on and his big brown eyes and his red shirt, and he was the man.
And yeah. How old were you when you met?
19 and 16.
Mm-hmm. So how long after you met did you end up dating and then eventually getting married?
We dated for a year and got married.
Seemed like a good thing to do.
So we've had the one guy shot himself in number 9, and then we had, since I took this place over, and this was really weird for me because I don't think I ever thought I would be dealing with something like that, being a landlord. And so the kid was kind of my friend just through here. And I knew he kind of had a troubled past, but we said, hey, you know, give you a chance, just trying to do the right thing. And he was a good kid. He was an electrician. And he, when he first came here, he helped me do some firearm stuff. And, you know, we kind of got to know each other. You guys may remember the story when the Fountain Green post office got shut down because they were getting so much mail from all over the country for that little girl that was dying of a rare disease. I still don't know if they ever figured out what she had. But the guy I'm talking about is the father of that little girl. So when he found out she was terminal, he come home and shot himself because he was so upset, I guess, or whatever, with that information. And so.
And so I used to own the motel over here. And so one night, one of my daughters, yes, sir.
Would you talk to me, Schreiber?
No, I'll get to it when I'm done here.
Go ahead and interview off.
You got it? All right. So anyway, when one of my daughters came and woke me up and told me that there was trouble at the motel, okay? And I guess the police had been called out 4 times before that, but I was not aware of that, okay? So I went out there and so I confronted this group of young people and things got physical and I punched one in the mouth. And then so I decided, and I'm telling you, from my headspace, this is where this all happened. I decided I was gonna go get my pistol and I was gonna run them off. Went and got my pistol, didn't run them off. They wouldn't leave, and they were trying to sneak around behind me, and this is the way I was feeling. And you know, in a situation like that, your perceptions are not always right. It's just your perceptions, you know. So I recognize that, and so I shot a round off in town into the ground to back them off, and it did work. It backed them off, but you know, I was not aware. But they were from the beginning of the incident. They were on the phone with their parents, or one of their parents, who was a deputy sheriff. And so he was reading them off code and law about what they could legally do and, you know, how to confront me and, you know, when they could shoot me legally and things like that. And so anyway, the police came in, and obviously with me being not the son of a deputy sheriff, I'm the one that went to jail.
We've been doing this flag across First North and Nephi for about 8 or 9 years. One of the firemen had the idea, right?
One year.
He actually had a big flag. He had it at his house. He says, hey, let's put it on the ladder truck. Put it up over the road there. Let's recognize the veterans and all those that fought for our country. He was pretty military guy and wanted to recognize him, so we started putting this flag up. Every year we're putting it up over the main street, or not, over First North until about 3 o'clock each day and recognize the veterans, so.
And what made you guys keep it going?
just the firemen took some good pride into it. I mean, it takes a little bit of work to get it up in the air, but they've took pride in doing it. So, and every year they look forward to doing it. So we've had this flag donated to us because they do get dirty. We've had to do a little bit of work to keep them clean, but we had this flag donated to us and we just keep it up every year. So we also put this flag up at firefighter funerals and things like that around the community, so.
Shotgun pickup trucks at the Jones's rubber plant, where all the guys end up. Beer drinking Boy Scouts living life like they ain't stuck on these quicksand streets. Their girls in a sling. I'm in my bedroom on the verge of a terrible thing. Round here we all take up our cross and hang on his holy name. But the cards that I was dealt get you thrown out of the game. Hey mama, can't you see your boy is wrapped up in the strangle silk of this cobweb town where culture is king. I'm in my bedroom on the verge of a terrible thing. I close my eyes, think of the water out at the Salt Creek when I was young. Down at Old Mill Park, half the town's in tow to crown the bathing beauty of the rodeo. While her mother fights back proud tears, a young cowboy gives the nod. The chute opens, the bull draws blood, and the gift is accepted by God. The chute opens, the bull draws blood, and the gift is accepted by God. In this barbed wire town of barbed wire dream. I'm in my bedroom on the verge of a terrible thing. I close my eyes, think of the water out at the Salt Creek. When I was young, I close my eyes, think of the water out at the Salt Creek. When I was young,
are you guys ready to begin the Bathing Beauty Contest for 2021?
Come on, you can do something more than that. Okay, are we ready?
We're ready. Let's back up and let them happen.
All right, let's get in the sunshine so these girls can shine. They've worked so hard all year long preparing for this moment. And you know what to do with your hands and voices to make them feel welcome. 1 through 18, they come out before you. Your opportunity to take your first look at the contestants for the Youth Stampede Bathing Beauty 2021 edition. One time, fans, lay something on them. Watch the step. Thank you, thank you. Talia Stevenson, sponsored Nevo Vision Clinic. She stands 5'4". Got strawberry blonde hair, blue eyes. She's 16 years young. She'll be starting her senior year in high school. She enjoys being outdoors and spending time with her family. She loves music, especially country music. She also loves anything outdoors.
She's a lifeguard, enjoys swimming and being in the sunshine. Her favorite part of Duval County is the Ute Stampede. And of course,
she's always down for an adventure and a good time. Paige is very outgoing. She loves helping others. She believes if you work hard, you can play harder.
She is 5'5", brown hair, and brown eyes. How about a giant round of applause?
But at the end of the day, only one can be crowned victor. Finishing number one for $600, Brantley Knight, contestant number 10, is your champion, ladies and gentlemen. Not only your top five, but your top 18. Every one of these competitors deserves something from you.
Okay, so it means to me, for one thing, that I'll be able to pay for college more. This definitely helps a lot with that. And it also means that girls who've never done this type of thing before have just as good a chance as anyone else to come in and win. And yeah.
Did you have a feeling that you might win, or?
Honestly, no. I've never really won anything like this before, and so I was really nervous when they started saying that she stands at 5'8", and blonde hair and green eyes. Another girl started walking out, so I thought it was her for sure. And then they called my number, so I was really surprised.
What made you choose to? Because you have to volunteer to compete. What made you choose to participate?
So my sister sent this to me, and she just sent me a link on Instagram. And was like, this would be really good for you to do. Please do it. And I was like, okay, all right. I thought it would be a really good confidence booster for everyone who does it. Thank you.
This is the plane taking off.
and some that you never will.
The pageantry is done, and now it's time for the toe-to-toe fight. Now it's time to get it lined up. Preston, cowboy time. Bear back right, we're going to start with the boots.
You've got to control the amount of style that this 19-year-old superstar has. He's earned $10 noise from you, but how about 83 points? Couple of kids got hit by a Union Pacific train, carrying sheet metal and household appliances through the pouring rain. They're planning on getting married after graduation. Had a little baby girl, trouble came and shut it down. Things like that ain't supposed to happen in this quiet town. Families are tight. Good people still don't deadbolt their doors at night in this quiet town. When we first heard opioid stories, they were always in whispering tones. Now banners of sorrow mark the front steps of childhood homes. Parents wept through daddy's girl eulogies and merit badge milestones, with their daughters and sons laying there lifeless in their suits and gowns. Somebody's been keeping secrets in this quiet town. They know how to live. Good people who lean on Jesus, they're quick to forgive in this quiet town. I'll find some reason to give, and I will walk with the dead and the living where I used to live. And every time I see my parents in the prime of their lives, offering their son the kind of love he could never put down, and part of me is still that stainless kid, lucky in this quiet town. Salt of the land, hardworking people, if you're in trouble, they'll lend you a hand. Here in this quiet town, the first crop of hay is up. School let out and the sun beats down. Smoke billows from a Sunday train. It cries away from a quiet town.
Thank you.